am Girish Kumar, a civil engineering graduate with 14 years of experience in construction industries. I have worked in various parts of construction like execution, planning, project management, QA/QC and procurement. The objective of this speech is, the first objective is scope for civil engineers. The second one is the job opportunities for the civil engineers. Apart from these two, are the third one is the current and ongoing projects, and fourth, sustainable and green building projects. So coming to the objective one, which is the scope of civil engineers. Civil engineers have a numerous scope, starting from surveying, which is the preliminary requirement of any construction project. Second is the geotechnical engineer. Third, hydrology engineer. And coming to the core construction, there are n number of works like execution, planning, QA/QC, project management, tendering and costing, estimation and billing, procurement, licensing to the private companies. It is not that the job is available only in a few sectors like a building construction or in a highway. The jobs are available various sectors, like in urban infrastructure we have flyovers, underpass, metro rail, footover bridges, street bridges. We have building projects like high-rise apartments, institutions. We have commercial complexes, shopping complexes. We have highways, we have railways, airport, harbor, solar plants. Jobs are not only available in one particular sector, or probably real estate or in infra. The jobs are available in private sectors, government sectors and defense. Apart from India, we have a huge requirement of civil engineers abroad. For instance, Gulf is the huge employer of civil engineers till date. They offer a job with good packages. And coming to the next objective is the job opportunities. Job opportunities, as I said, there are numerous, like you have metro rails, highway infrastructure. The opportunities have to be explored by the civil engineers. Now, what are the current projects? The current projects happening in and around Bangalore and Karnataka is, one is the BMRCL phase 1, BMRCL phase 2, which is happening in Tumkur Road, Hosur Road, Mysore Road and then in Kanapura Road. The BT, the bitumen stopping in the internal roads of Bengaluru City, white topping for all arterial roads connecting the national highways of Bengaluru City, and the flyovers which is happening in Kormangala water tank and Nelamangala near International Exhibition Center. There is a steel bridge upcoming near Shivananda Circle. And there is a so these are the current ongoing projects. And what is the proposed projects or the upcoming projects? The upcoming projects are the BMRCL phase 3. Second is the Mysore Road widening from 4 meter to 6 meters. Third is the high speed rail corridor from Chennai to Mysore via Bangalore.
That Mysore road is 4 lanes to 6 lanes, not 4 meters to 6 meters. Okay, no issue.
4 lane to 6 lane
actually. Yeah,
correct. It is not 4 meters to 6 meters. And we have a signal free outer ring road. And apart from Karnataka, if you see, apart from Bengaluru, you have irrigation projects going on
all over
Karnataka. So, and apart from Karnataka, if you see, there are n number of projects happening, infrastructure projects happening, like Cochin Metro, extension of Chennai Metro, extension of Hyderabad Metro, Jaipur Metro and even in Ahmedabad Metro. So these are the major infrastructure projects which are ongoing and also upcoming. So what is that which is need to be done? And coming to the sustainable buildings or the green buildings. The green buildings are also having a huge scope, because IGBC is the body which is leading to obtain green building for all the upcoming projects in India. In order to get into these projects or get the job opportunity into these projects, how are the engineers going to account system is there's somebody which needs to be trained, who needs to train these students. Who is that? Now I think Prayojana CMTI is the institute framed by experienced working professionals for more than 20 years. The objective of Prayojana CMTI is to bridge the gap between the academics and industry requirements, thereby creating a career, enhancing their skills as per the industry requirement. Prayojana CMTI, how do they train? They train the students by classroom teaching, internship, site visits, opportunity to meet the entrepreneurs wherein they share their knowledges, technical know-how on the requirements, scopes and new technologies. So the Prayojana CMT is an opportunity for the engineers to make use of the process to get through the knowledge and get a placement. Now the Prayojana is also into IGBC. The Prayojana, what is IGBC? Indian Green Building Council. IGBC is basically a body to promote green buildings. What are green buildings? Green buildings are basically buildings which consume natural materials than man-made materials. They utilize complete ventilation, lighting and water resources available, thereby making the building or the project energy efficient and sustainable. So all these new technologies or new upcoming scopes, Prayojana CMTI is training the students, the engineering students, the fourth semester students, so that they know what is that to be learned and get accustomed to the requirements of the industry. So I would request all the students, so please go to Prayojana CMTI, get trained, get technical know-how, get knowledge and get a placement. All the best. Good luck.
Thank you. Thank you, Girish.